Good evening, it's good to see you everyone. My name is Octavian, and I've got a video here where I'm going to try and briefly and succinctly cover exactly how timeless jewels work, and likely fail at the task because they're a bit complicated. I am using one in my build though, so I've got one for a demonstration, and a few more in my inventory that I can demonstrate to show the differences between some of them as well. So, there's two very important aspects to every single, or three very important aspects to every single timeless jewel. There's the base kind of jewel, there's the name associated with your jewel, and there's the number associated with your jewel. The rest of it is kind of just flavor text. The fact that it says commissioned X number of coins to commemorate Y, that doesn't mean anything really, it's just the number and the name that are important. If you look at a Karui one, it's commanded X amount of warriors under Y general. It's purely flavor, the number and the name are the important things. And then the base type is which faction you got the jewel from. So any Lethal Pride is going to be a Karui jewel, any Elegant Hubris is going to be an Eternal Empire jewel, and so on and so forth. Each of them have their own fancy special name, and they're a slightly different color for each of the factions, with the Maraketh being the rarest, only three or four of those being listed on the server so far from what I've seen, which is a little absurd. Now, the jewel I'm using in my build, and the one I'm going to use for demonstration purposes, is an Elegant Hubris. But actually, for most players, and you'll see why in a little bit, I do recommend the Karui jewels. They're the easiest to work with. But I wanted specifically the Supreme Ego Keystone, which does mean I need to use a Chittis Elegant Hubris. And that brings me to my first point. The Keystone is the easiest thing to control out of these jewels, since there's only three options for each faction's jewel, and as such, divining to the correct option is pretty easy, or just buying one with the right name. Elegant Hubris has Kadiro, Chittis, and Victario. Chittis doesn't show up when you hold Alt here, since the range is Kadiro to Victario, and apparently Chittis gets to go in the middle. But I do have a Chittis one here as well, and that gives me Supreme Ego. On pwee.db.tw, there is a full list of these keystones, if you want to just see what all of them do. I will have a link to that, but I want to keep this video relatively short, so I'm not going to be going through every single keystone. Have hovered this for a little while, so you can see which one I'm using if you like. So yeah, the keystone's pretty easy to control and to guarantee. All you have to do is just get one with the right name. So specifically for my build, I always need a Chittis. However, the number portion is much harder. As you can see, there is a massive range numerically here, and that number is randomly rolled anywhere from 2,000 to 160,000, and that's independent of the name as well. And the important thing that that number does is modify your smaller nodes within the radius. So, any Elegant Hubris jewel from the Eternal Empire is going to simply turn off all of your stat nodes. So, things like Strength, Int, Dex, those 10-point travel nodes, those all get turned off. Any other small travel nodes as well, you can see these ones coming out of which are turned off. But the larger notables get transformed into much more powerful nodes than are usually found on the passive tree. Things like 50 cold res, or 80 physical damage, or 80 minion damage. More powerful in terms of a larger number, not always being something you really want, though. Like plus 50 cold res not being particularly impactful. The jewel I'm currently using, I rolled into 10% max life here, and 10% max life here. But what I want to show you is that that is not static, and it's controlled by the numbers. So because I have a jewel that says 6,100, these two nodes are both 10% max life. But if I swap over to a different Elegant Hubris that says 105,560, instead I get 80% spell crit and 50% chill avoidance, which, you know, is not quite as good. It also has the wrong keystone, so I wouldn't use it anyway. But you get the point. It can be very difficult to guarantee a good jewel, and just kind of to demonstrate that, I'm going to sacrifice some Divine Orbs to RNG gods and hope to hit a better jewel than what I have. But because I also specifically really want Supreme Ego as my keystone, my odds are particularly low because I also need to hit Chittis at the same time as hitting a favorable outcome with the RNG seed. But we did hit Chittis, so there's a chance this is an upgrade. Let's see. We landed on 80% minion damage and 80% minion damage, which is kind of absurd for any build that would be using Chittis in this spot when caring about minion damage. So maybe I don't want to roll over this again, because the chances of hitting this again are incredibly slim. As well as this, you have Endurance Charge gen for 3 points, gain an Endurance Charge every second if you've been hit recently. That's just actually a really good minion Elegant Hubris and not something I anticipated hitting. Alright, I don't want to roll over this anymore. It's not good for my build, but I'm going to hold on to that, because that's a really interesting jewel. So you can see how these things can get out of hand, because you have super powerful rolls, like those 80% damage rolls for, you know, their respective builds, as well as endurance charge gen like Juggernaut Ascendancy, but then you have really, really wimpy stuff like plus 50 cold res, or, man, this 20% flash duration isn't terrible, but probably not worth the 3 points. So, yeah, you might end up with complete garbage, you might end up with absolutely godly notables. It's all entirely RNG, and there is, most importantly, and the big point I really wanted to make this video, no way of telling before you buy the jewel and put it in your tree, because if I put this jewel somewhere else in my tree, it's gonna do different stuff. I'm getting 80% crit, 10% damage per endurance charge, 80% crit for spells, and, you know, whatever else these other nodes are doing, the point is made. Yeah, until you buy the jewel, unless you can buy one that has the exact same number as someone else's jewel and you know what their jewel is doing, or unless you can convince someone to let you test it before you pay them the money to buy it, you have no way of knowing whether it's going to be good. So it is really just a crapshoot, and if you're anticipating including one of these jewels in your build that completely transforms nodes and not just one of the Karui ones, which I'll get to in a second, I would only ever include it as like a final edition when you have money to burn on divines or money to burn on buying additional copies of your specific jewel, whichever is cheaper. That said, for people who don't have a ton of money to burn but do want to use historic jewels, I can recommend the Karui ones. Not only are they the cheapest, but also they behave a little bit differently than Elegant Hubris jewels do. That's a lethal pride. So if we throw that into the tree, you'll see that it's not actually transforming the nodes. These are all still giving me whatever, you know, Firewalker, Arcanist, Dominion, even the Int nodes, whatever they used to give. They're just giving me a little extra on top. So Int nodes will give me +2 strength. In fact, any traveling stat node will. So Dex +2 strength, Strength +12 instead of 10, that sort of thing. But if we look at some of these notables, you'll see I'm getting 20% melee damage from Quick Recovery. I'm getting, I think this is 15% melee crit multi from Explosive Runes. Not super synergistic there, but eh. We're getting, I think, just more totem damage out of Shamanistic Fury, which is actually pretty good. Yeah, an extra 20% totem damage on top of Shamanistic Fury makes that a very powerful node. We're getting 1% life regen out of Firewalker. We're getting 5% of Fizz taken as fire from Arcanist Dominion. You can get some pretty potent stuff, and you're not giving up anything for it outside of your one historic jewel slot, because you can only have one historic jewel in a build, and the jewel slot itself. But if you find a good enough Karui one, that could definitely be worth it. So, yeah, if you're on more of a budget and you still want to play around with some historic jewels, I definitely recommend the Karui over any of the other factions. Maraketh do a similar thing in terms of just being additive to your nodes rather than completely transforming them, but Maraketh jewels are like 30 or 40x, so not really a budget option. That said, I hope this elucidated matters for you. If you have any further questions on timeless jewels or really anything else you want to ask or throw my way, feel free to in the comments below, and I hope to see you in the next one.